Welcome to DWBIADDA channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Hello everyone. Welcome back to another video tutorial on deep learning with Keras. We have already discussed on two major variants of neural networks. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss on the final type of neural net, recurrent neural networks. Let's begin the session. Recurrent neural networks, or RNN, is a very important variant of neural network, heavily used in natural language processing. In a general neural network, an input is processed through a number of layers and an output is produced with an assumption that two successive inputs are independent of each other. This assumption is, however, not true in real-life scenarios. For example, if one wants to predict the price of a stock at a given time, we have to consider the dependence on previous observations. We can imagine RNN as a multi-layer neural network with each layer representing the observations at a certain time. So RNN uses an additional loop of weights. In this session, we will use a special variant of RNN, LSTM, which are able to look back longer than normal RNN. The applications of RNN include speech recognition, language modeling, translation, and image captioning. In this section, we are going to discuss on the architecture of recurrent neural network. We already know that RNN contains a loop of weights. If we unroll this, it will be presented by a sequence of networks. This XT is the input at a time step T. ST is the hidden state at time step T. It is calculated based on the previous hidden state and the input at current step. We can represent this by a function of weight U into XT plus this weight W into ST minus 1. The function F usually is a non-linearity such as 10H or ReLU. Finally, this OT is the output at step T. We use a softmax function on the input of this layer. So the output will be softmax function with V into the output of hidden layer. It will follow the same rule for every timestamp. In our demonstration, we use IMDb dataset. This dataset was created by researchers at Stanford University and published in a paper on 2011. It contains of 50,000 movie reviews from IMDb users that are labeled as either positive or negative. Original database contains all the reviews from IMDb users. The reviews are pre-processed and each one is encoded as a sequence of word indexes in the form of integer. The words within the reviews are indexed by their overall frequency within the dataset. For this word UD, we have the index value 2289. So system tokenized the word UD and indexed it with the number 2289. The input of the dataset only contains the integers. This one means highest frequent word in the dataset. Similarly, 14 means 14th most frequent word in the dataset. And the output only contains two classes, 0 for negative and 1 for positive review. In today's session, we will build an LSTM model, train that using training dataset, and finally predict the output from test inputs. Now, we are going to Jupyter and work with a complete sentiment analysis using LSTM model. First, we import sequential model API from Keras. In this demonstration, we are going to use dense LSTM and embedding layers, and we have to import them from Keras. We import sequence preprocessing, which will help us to preprocess the training and test data. Keras dataset contains IMDb data, and we will import this. Finally, to manipulate our data, we use NumPy. In this section, we load IMDb dataset using load data function. This load data helps us to split the dataset into training and test set. We also set num underscore words as 10,000, so it will work with top 10,000 words. This print helps us to display the shape of the input and outputs. And our training and test both are containing 25,000 data. Now we explore the data set. First we combine the inputs as data and outputs as targets. We have two output classes, 0 and 1, and we are working with 9,998 unique words. This block is also displaying that average review length is 234.75 with the standard deviation 173. This code block is displaying the inputs and its associated outcome. For the first review, the input dataset contains a set of integers where this 14 means 14th most frequent word from dataset. Similarly, this 112 means 112th most frequent word from the dataset. The output of the associated data is 1, so it was a positive review. In the next block, we have printed the complete first movie review. In the dictionary, all the frequent words are stored with its index value. Suppose for the word spider, the associated index is 52,016. So every word in the review will be represented as an integer index and stored as input. We have displayed the complete set of token and associated index value. Next, we need to truncate and pad the input sequences so that they will be in the same length for modeling. The model will learn the zero values carry no information, so indeed, the sequences are not the same length in terms of content, but same length vectors are required to perform the computation in Keras. Now we construct our model. The first layer is embedded layer that uses 32 length vectors to represent each word. As this is the first layer, we have to specify the input dimension, which is 500. The next layer is LSTM layer with 100 memory units. Our final output layer is a dense layer with one node. As this is a classification problem, we will use sigmoid as activation function so that the output will be in the range of 0 and 1. This summary function is generating the model summary. We have already compiled our model with the loss function binary cross entropy, optimizer as Adam, and matrix as accuracy. In this section, we will discuss on the model training. For this training, we have already used the epoch as 10. So there was 10 iterations. We already know that the more the epochs, more the accuracy and less the loss. We also set the batch as 64, as our input data set contained 25,000 data. So there was 391 batches of 64 samples each. We have already trained this model, setting X train and Y train as an input and output for the model, and X test and Y test as the validation set of the model. It took around 50 minutes. It started with the loss 0.6475 and accuracy 0.6794. With the advancement of epochs, it was gradually decreased. Finally, when it finished the iterations, the final loss was 0.0387, which was negligible, and accuracy was around 98%. And for the validation, the loss was 0.65 and accuracy was around 85%. We also used our evaluate function to evaluate our model. This evaluate function returned the loss and accuracy. This print function returned the model loss and accuracy in percentage. So our model accuracy was around 85.15% for X test and Y test data. In this final section, we displayed the original expected result and the predicted result. We displayed only first 200 results. It predicted very well from the test data. It predicted 0 as 0. For this example, it also predicted 1 correctly. So our model predicted the outcomes with the 85% accuracy. That's all from Jupyter. We are returning to the presentation. Today we have discussed on LSTM, which is a special variant of recurrent neural networks. And we built our model, and our model worked fine with 85% accuracy. So that's all for today. See you in the next tutorial.